Gilman, thank you so, so much. I don't remember the last time we played Gilman. I think it was with Bang 6 years ago. It's hot out of motherfucker. So we played the show last night. I was also sick. On top of that, I'm losing my voice. So I'm gonna give you everything I got. It's a 92 Sentra, Toyota, or Nissan. So give it up to the first three bands, three beautiful ladies. Each one doing their own thing. Jawstruck, Santa Cruz, what's up? Give it up for No Right. Give it up. The show, I don't think, would have been either as good or as appropriate to have each of those bands bring something different to the table. So it's important for all you guys to support your local shit before you support the shit that comes through the doors from other towns. It's hard enough being a fucking woman in this world. You gotta work twice as hard to get half the fucking recognition. And I've dealt with a mother that had to do that every single fucking day. So respect all the ladies in here trying to do something. That last song was a brand new song called Reaper. People are asking, so like, are you a band again or what? I mean, we're playing fucking shows, man. What do you think? We're writing new songs. What do you think? We're a very unapologetic band, so I don't really give a fuck what people say. And I don't think anyone should apologize for who they are at the root of themselves or how you feel. But always be prepared because someone's going to throw stones and cast their shit your way to test you. So you hold on to who you are. Whether motherfuckers tell you it's right or wrong, that's not what the Bible says. It's what you chose to be or some shit like that. You hold on to who you are. Because someone's always trying to make you something else, something that makes them comfortable, something that fits their model, tell you what's pretty, what's not, what's his, what's hers, what is he, what is she. And fuck it, man, at this point, you ain't got time to waste time on motherfuckers like that. So write them off and keep doing you, whoever the fuck that is.
Oh!
Yo, who's seen Rock Live before? Shit. Thank you so, so much for coming back and still giving a fuck, honestly. So, who's here? This is the first time they've ever seen us. Holy shit, thank you so much for taking that chance on us, for giving a fuck and showing up. I think some of my favorite shows are the ones where I showed up not knowing what was going to happen or what I was expecting, because I heard one of my favorite bands. I'm like, I got to see this in real life. I got CDs aren't enough. Tapes aren't enough. MP3s aren't fucking enough. The thing about hardcore, you can't do that shit from your room, man. I swear to God, you can try and you can judge and you can criticize on the fucking internet and do whatever the fuck you want, but if you're not in these rooms, you're not a part of this. I'll tell you that right now. Whether you got a fucking instrument, or whether you're just paying the $10, $20 at the door to support local bands or bigger bands that are coming through and supporting your scene, this isn't about us. This is about you and where you fucking live. Start shows. Put shows in your fucking garage. I don't give a fuck. Do your fucking part. And then you can make whatever statements you think are necessary about your scene because you're putting an effort. But motherfuckers like to sit behind and not do a damn thing except lift their fingers and talk their talk and say what they say and never show their face. Fuck you. Where I come from, you are accountable for anything you say or type. And it's amazing that venues like this prove that the DIY mentality can stand the test of time. Places like the Gilman that are still doing what they're doing after so fucking long and having their moral code of what they think is right and applied to their fucking venue because they've been doing this and they don't want bullshit coming in, bigots coming in, racists coming in, homophobes coming in. You leave that shit at the door, man, or you just don't fucking show up at all because you're not fucking welcome here. Growing up, I was taught that things like words like nigger or faggot, these things were appropriate. They were normalized in my childhood. I thought these things were okay because the people above me taught me it was okay. It's okay to hate these people for no fucking reason. I don't know why. That's what I was taught. So when I got into punk rock, I started questioning every fucking thing. Everything I was taught, everything the church told me, everything school told me, everything I learned from my parents, from all the gangsters on the block, from every Mexican to every African, to wonder why they hate the way they hate. And all they knew is because someone above them told them. And it was taught. And I knew I didn't want my brother to do the same thing, to be taught these things. So I brought him into these rooms as a young kid. I was a teenager, he couldn't have been more than fucking 10 years old. And so I dragged him these things and showed him, you don't have to think that way anymore. You don't have to swallow everything that did you. There's something about me and my brother. Quiet! Thank you. We have a few songs left. And we'll get the fuck out of here. First of all, big shout out to the beautiful ones. Arizona hardcore. The Almighty, Shibalba. I said this last night, but this whole weekend, just doing LA and Northern California. Me and Nate from Zimbabwe were sitting in our kitchen eating fucking avocado toast. He loves that shit, but whatever, man. And he's like, we should play some shows. I was like, yeah, sounds tight. So we play some fucking shows. Yeah, go back to Washington, man. This fucking, this Khalifa, man, get the fuck out of here. Yo, so, I went away for a minute, right? I did some things, went to some places that I didn't know I needed to go. And a lot of people, oh, what the fuck, you want a loser, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, I'm a fucking loser, I've been a loser. I just happen to do some weird shit sometimes. But I was sitting in county, and there's this fucking kid just shaking. We didn't fuck with him too much. We didn't even talk to him, he was just shaking. So he was dope sick, right? You know, Ohio has a bad opioid epidemic. And I'm like, hey man, like, what the fuck are you in here for? He's out of possession. I was like, sick. He's like, I only got like 100 days or some shit. I'm like, well, what's your bail? He's like, $1,000. So, bail is literally 10%. As long as you can find 10%, it's only $100, right? And I'm like, you got brothers? You got sisters? He's like, yeah, I got three brothers and I got a mom. I was like, well, ooh, that's like $25 each. And he scams that shit. And this kid tells me, he's like, they don't talk to me. It's my 19th birthday today. And I was selling dope to my family. And they're not going to bail me out. And I thought about my situation and how fucking grateful I should be. No matter how low I've gotten, someone has it lower. And not to say it discredits my misery or whatever the fuck, but I need to be grateful for the shit around me. People still give a fuck. You know, people call me, people worry. You do dumb shit, you get faced with dumb ass, you know, consequences. And that's the way in life, half the shit is figuring it out. But, and he was laughing about it. And what's so funny? He's like, I don't know, man. I feel old. You know, this is just kind of silly to me. I'm dope sick in county, and I feel like I'm 30 years old. I'm a motherfucker, I'm 30 years old. And I was like, I don't know, man. It just feels funny because I don't know what else there is. And I couldn't help but just like, fuck, man. Fuck this place. And fuck that lifestyle. I'm not a drug addict, but I suffered at the hands of a drug addict. And I know now what that shit does to you, to your decision making, and to the people that actually give a fuck about you. So hold on to those in your life. There's only one thing certain. Everyone you love will die. That's the process, and there's no guarantee that tomorrow you'll wake up and they'll still be there. So hold on to them. This song's called Laughing Without Living.